Alright, so here we are. The Immortals once again, the blue coated side to the south, their opponents BP Super Friends as the yellow orange team to the north.
Yeah, and taking a quick look at the tank line is very standard and not too surprising coming out from both teams. BP Super Friends, of course, going with the dual AMX 13s, of course, Batman, actually, and Tear in that AMX 13 this time, so it's not going to be Batman or Robin, but Robin is in that T69 and then Anuto.
Actually, the previous set, too, I was assuming. Like always, it would be Batman
and
Robin.
Oh, was it Anatole?
Yeah, no, it was Antares on that 1390 as well. So actually, Robin who was with the T69 last set around too.
All right, but their opponents, the Immortals, going with a slightly lighter setup than we're used to seeing them, going with dual AMX 50s and then a T32 and then T69 plus one AMX 13.
Kind of surprising too.
And Lucas, man.
Antares taking a shot already by the Sirius.
Oh, another one
as well. Like, yeah, you know what? That's the thing. Yeah. A little too predictable, once again. When you're playing against PvP, you want to have at least some arguments down to the southwest. Because you know that Batman's going to show up out there. And usually it's Robin, now it's Antares. But perfectly well countered.
Oh,
and look at that Batman being surrounded as well. It's not looking too good early on.
Yeah, these guys are a little bit trapped at this point.
I mean,
the Immortals knew exactly what they were going to do. They immediately sent both the Sirius and Iron Buzz over there to the Western Isle, and the second Batman and Antares came down to that southern part of the map. They just got shot out. I mean, Antares and Batman now, they're also kind of trapped from the tanks on the hilltop. Look at Hades in position. So if Batman and Antares try to run from this, they're going to get shot. If they try to engage, they're going to get shot no matter what.
Very well done. Although Batman did take a lot of damage from that.
Uh-oh.
He goes down. Can the Sirius go down? No,
oh,
please do not. This is a win for the Immortals.
Most definitely.
Very well done.
Yeah, the Sirius not even going down there. He's still alive. He traded that for two AMX 13s. Completely worth it right there. Hades took a little bit of damage, but honestly, losing two tier 8s is just too big of a loss.
Like you said, from the get-go, Antares and Batman just were completely trapped out there as well. They couldn't even retreat. They couldn't advance. And it's just very well done to send the Sirius and Iron Buzz in support as well. The Sirius alone would not have been nearly enough to counter that, but... once again, I think, like you mentioned, really just excellent anticipation coming from the Immortals. And that's why I started talking about the strat even before we started the set, because considering how one-sided it was last time around, PvP showed up with this revamp tactic on the West Isle. I was kind of skeptical as to, okay, if they go with the same thing, no doubt the Immortals had seen their play last week, so... Well, if you ask me, it was rather easy to counter.
Well, the thing is, I think this time around, I think Batman and Tear were just a little bit too aggressive with that shot, with that push down the Western Isle. Last week, I don't think they were that aggressive that early on. I think Batman and I think Robin was in the AMX 13 last week. They just kind of roamed around their team, like, or just around the northern part of the Western Isle. And then it wasn't until later on, once they got vision on the southern part, that they pushed down there. But a little bit I think, just overcommitment to that. And I think that's what just really cost them. Had they just waited a little bit more, had they even sent in a T1 first, they would have completely spotted both the Sirius and Iron Buzz in those two respective tanks, just waiting for them to come there.
Well, and speaking of the Sirius, excellent positioning, like, you know, slightly with the high ground, but hiding behind a rock. So basically, Antares did not know the Sirius was there until he came out of cover.
Yeah.
And he already took two shots when he finally found it out. So very well done.
Wow, Hades taking a lot of damage right now, though, both from Anuto and from the Western Isle right now in the Robin. Yeah, doing a lot of damage down to 200 health.
Did take quite a bit of damage too, and so did the Sirius. You know what? Maybe I spoke too soon. This might not be game over yet.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, huge
shot.
Once again, Hades, like, T32 going down. That is very surprising because there was such an overwhelming advantage earlier on. And now, all of a sudden, maybe PvP still has a shot at this because Savage is really low and the Sirius is one shot away from dying too.
Yeah, most definitely. Honestly, I guess PvP weren't as far behind as they were, or they just made up so much ground that they were behind in. And right now, like you mentioned, I think it's definitely the Sirius. Yeah, look at that, down to 181 health. If he gets taken out, it's gonna be completely tied up, and PvP will definitely have a chance of coming back in this. You know, Iron Buzz is still full, and Neverbest than the two others.
Savage can take a lot of
fairly health. Yeah, Savage is fairly low, but Neverbest is kind of healthy still, and he should have plenty of time to have his autoloader up. But Robin, as long as Robin and Little Mac. As long as those two tanks can unleash their autoloaders on the right targets, they can definitely collect.
Well, I mean, once again, there's still a huge advantage going to the Immortals that goes without there's no question about that. But really not as comfortable as I thought it would be for the Immortals. Matter of fact, there was an excellent bit of micromanagement on Central Hilltop. Like, you know, Anuto and Little Mac doing wonders. Now, they're getting shot by Iron Bust in West Isle there. But, you know, if
they gotta
Robin,
be careful.
Yeah, if Robin can provide, like, just, you know, a little bit of support fire, because Iron Bust is all alone out there. Yeah, Robin's probably gonna.
He actually has no idea still.
Yeah, yeah.
And now he's gonna know though.
Oh, he took a shot though, and a second one right there. And
yeah, Robin's gonna win this.
Yeah, because he's gonna unleash his other loader, and you know, Iron Bust is still reloading at this point.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So Robin, I think he's out of bullets now. So yeah. Robin is just gonna back up just a little bit. Iron Bust should have his auto loader up soon, so he has to get under cover. Whereas the battle in the middle of the hill, look at this, Anuto falling. So it looks like the Immortals realizing the slight advantage there.
Well,
they
went in at the right time. Once again, it was too much of a deficit, like 2 1390s going down from the...
See, I mean, had Robin been in the Central Hilltop, in that firefight in the Central Hilltop that we just saw, it might have gotten PvP saver, but I
but
mean,